Ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna need you to stand up and take a shot of tequila. Cause it's about that time.
What up, Coach Tim and the rest of the High fam? It's your boy. Just wishing you a happy 50th birthday. Congratulations on turning half a 100. Turn up for your boy.
Wayne, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Happy 50th, Mr. Hyde.
Happy birthday, Mr. Hyde.
Happy 50th birthday, Tim.
50. Congratulations.
Happy 50th birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Can't believe you're 50. That's crazy.
Happy birthday, Timmy.
Hi, Cousin Tim. I hope you have a wonderful 50th birthday.
Happy 50th birthday to you, Timothy.
Happy birthday, Timmy.
Happy 50th birthday, Dad.
1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday, Mr. Tim. 50 years young. That's awesome.
Happy birthday, Mr. Tim. You're 50. That's half of 100.
Happy birthday, old man.
Hey Tim, happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
What's happening, Coach Tim? It's Halloween. Just want to wish you a happy birthday, man.
Happy birthday, Mr. Tim!
I just want to say happy 50th birthday to Mr. Tim.
Happy birthday!
Happy 50th birthday.
Well, happy birthday, Tim!
Happy 50th birthday to my favorite brother-in-law.
Happy birthday, brother-in-law. Happy 50th birthday.
Happy 50th birthday, Uncle Tim. I love you and this is your nephew, Jeremiah and Rooster.
Could not let this day go by without wishing you a happy 50th birthday, Tim.
Hi, Tim. Happy birthday. Happy 50th. Welcome to the club.
Big Tim, a.k.a. Little Ronald. What's going on, man? We out here poolside,
chilling at 15, East Big Sky Drive in Hampton, Eastside.
Happy birthday to you.
Birthday, Mr. Hyde, man. Hope all is well with the family, man. Hope to see you soon, actually. Christian Hammonds, Prince of Peace, Eagles. All right.
Look. I feel blessed. Way up, I feel blessed. Straight up. Look, I live the life I deserve. Bless. A vacay, I feel better at work. I mean, whatever it's worth, I give whatever I'm worth. For my nigga who gon' go to hell and back for me, I'ma give him heaven on earth for a hell of a check, yeah, whichever come first. Blessings on blessings on blessings. Look at my life, man, that's lessons on lessons on lessons. I treat the beat like it's a reverend. I tell the truth like, Father, forgive me. These are all my confessions, man. This wasn't luck, it was destined. I done lost homies who been with me since Ed, Ed, and Eddie, who flip like confetti. And then when you back, they back to call you dog. That shit can get petty. Don't get no dap to me, dude. Funny thing about talking behind my back is that it just keep coming back to me. Was off for a sec, now it's back to me. You mad at me, this ain't what I want, man. This what it had to be. This is that late night working after three, man. This is why my old girl was mad at me. This why I'm your majesty, man. The click is the tightest, the poop the tightest. The drinks are the coldest, the future the brightest. The feet not divided, the love is divided. And I just gotta thank God that we got it. Bless. I don't know what I would do without a crew. Look like we robbed a bank, but all we make is deposits. Your profit with profit, oh God.
I'm here for a good time, not a long time, you know I haven't had a good time in a long time, you know I'm way up, I feel blessed. Way up, I feel blessed.
Straight up.
I'm way up, I feel blessed.
Straight up,
way up, I feel blessed.
Uncle Tim, what's up with you, baby boy? My man turned the big 5-0, congratulations. Yeah, I mean, first, you know, everyone who's looking at this, I want everyone to be quiet. And I want you to get serious. And let's take a moment of silence. I know what you're asking. Why do we take this moment of silence? Because we need to show reverence. Because Uncle Tim and I are the reigning BidWiz champions. So let's clap it up. Clap those up. You the man, Uncle Tim. But anyway, on a funny note, so I think of a funny story about Uncle Tim. Uncle Tim, how come? Got a question. Every time I see you, it looks like you have stole poor Jordan's t-shirts and put them on, man. Put the weights down, man. You're busting out your shirts, bro. He needs his clothes, man. But anyway, love you, man. Congratulations. Hope all the fam, everybody's good out there.
81, 82, 83.
My funny story actually takes place at Morningfield. I remember one day I was real young, but I remember it was like you stayed home from work or something, and I went in your room. And I remember you were just like, you got up and you were like, I look like Elephant Man. And it was just the funniest thing ever, because you really look like an elephant, because your face was like bloated up with like medicine or whatever they did to you.
Say it, maybe 83, 84, somewhere in there. But when I first met you, I can't remember the dates. Maybe because I'm getting old. But I can't remember the date. But I remember when I first met you, I never forget. Yeah, on a plaid shirt. with some real show cargo pants, and they were tight. I can't remember you had some penny loafers on with a quarter in them, but I know what it was. I didn't really know you, but I knew your two brothers, Mark and Ali. But the next day at school, I remember joking them about what you had on. Well, anyway, I hope you don't dress like that now.
Hey, Mr. Hyde, this is Christian. I just wanted to wish you a happy 50th. Hope you're doing well. Jordan asked us to tell you a funny story about knowing you and everything. And the first thing that came to mind was how many times I wound up talking to you either during Coach Ed yelling and cussing at us or after Coach Ed yelling and cussing at us, which with Coach Ed happens about every 5 minutes, and especially with Devontae about every 2 minutes. But no, I just wanted to wish you a happy 50th. Hope you're doing well, and here's 50 more. Happy birthday, Mr. Rod.
Since junior high school, college, and till this day, which I'm 26, you've always asked me for rent because of all the times I've been at your place. So my funny story and moment would be when you finally traveled on to the University of North Texas campus, our territory where I live. Dan, you were helping Jazz move, and you're getting something out of the car. And I just remember looking at you and stating, hey, do you have my rent money? And I think we both just started laughing because it was the first time I was actually able to ask you that same exact question that you always ask me. You've been asking me for years. But, you know, I know you're going to keep asking me forever, but that's okay.
I'm sorry to tell you there has been a change of plans. I am taking this back to North Carolina. I appreciate the birthday gift. Thank you very much.
I hope you enjoy it. You know, just makes me think back on the times you used to give me rides to practice all the times. You used to just zoom through the speed bumps like nobody else was in the car. Almost bumped my head on the thing on the ceiling, but anyways, and also how your head bobbled when you listen to music, head bobbing like this all the time. You used to crack us up in the back seat, but anyways, I appreciate that. How you always gave us a ride. I probably didn't appreciate it back then, but looking back at it now, driving little teenagers across the city and stuff, spoiled teenagers, I appreciate that, and it's not taken for granted. And once again, just want to wish you a happy 50th birthday. I hope you enjoy it.
Hey Tim, remember that time you and I and Tony were taking shots of tequila? Well, this one's to you. One tequila, two tequila, three tequila, floor. Happy birthday, Tim.
Remember that having you, man, who's somewhere. I remember little Jordan sagging. He was sagging, and he was like, what big deal for him? So he got mad. It was kind of funny. Kind of put him on blast in front of everybody. And when it was in Dallas at Six Flags, and you made Jordan ride his overcoat. And he was right. He was crying, that was funny too, man, that was funny, but I just want to wish you a happy birthday, wish you the best, see you soon, hopefully, down the road sometime, yeah, just take it easy.
We don't have any funny stories, because you were mean when you worked with me, and I ain't really like you, so I don't really have any funny stories, except for that one. Happy birthday!
I recall when you guys moved in your house over on Morningfield. We were moving in and helping you guys get settled, and you know, Jordan, I hate to put you on blast, baby, but this is about you just as well, much as it is about your dad. But I think you got a little bored. I don't know, maybe Jasmine was outside playing or doing whatever she does, but you got a little bored and you decided everybody's working on the house, I want to do something too. So you got a crayon or a permanent marker or something, and you just went around the house and you just marked up the wall. It was like you were going la-da-da-da-da-da-da. Anyway, by the time your dad realized what was happening, honey, I thought you were a goner that night because your daddy might have killed you if you had not been his child.
So going back to 94, I guess the first thing that I would call out would be when we used to get together. I guess I still had my jet in those days. I come by, pick you up. And we go hang out a little bit, go down to the, you know, little bayou, you know, San Antonio, just run the strip in San Antonio, hit the club a little bit. Tanya wouldn't let you come out in them days, but I guess since you was with Big Cuz, she let you come out. We go to the club, get your head twisted a little bit, bring you back home, and those kind of things. But we just had a bunch of great times during those days. And I guess the funniest time, and then this is probably public knowledge by now, was the night over at our crib on 7331 Walla Walla right there. We all chilling, me, you, and Tanya, and I think the babies was there. And Steve, Diane, and for whatever reason, we got into that tequila, and that became a night to remember.
I do remember the time that I came out to Jasmine's graduation, and you told me I had to sleep out there where the dog slept. And of course, you know what? When I think about it, you used to say I was your dog, so maybe you took it a little literal. That ain't funny. Anyway, the other thing was, remember the time we was at the reunion? I used to come quite frequently, and we was there, me, you, and Arnetta. And you said, why does he keep getting this coconut and pineapple cake? He ain't in the family. And from that day on, I never got another one. That was funny for you, not for me.
You see, I have this Eagle shirt on. I had to dive in the back of my closet, crawl, look all over the place, but I found it. Unfortunately, they probably won't win this year. Jordan will probably edit this out. You know, he gets really emotional when it comes to Eagles, whether it be live or a video game or a hat or a shirt, whatever it be. Don't say anything bad because Jordan will come through. Knock you off.
So, a funny story. Well, as you know, we've had some challenges throughout our time together, which I really now see as an opportunity, and opportunities to see how much we really can be there for each other, namely how much I can be there for you. But my funny story is about you trying to navigate crutches and balance the lack of a gift of dexterity. Kind of got in the way of being able to navigate or get from place to place with the crutches. But one place in particular is that was that transition between the garage and the entryway into our house. And I just told you to swing like Superman. And we eventually got there with a little humor, of course.
So I got two funny stories, but Kim has asked me not to share the second one until you turn 60. So this first one, you remember that little blue car that you guys got me in high school? Well, you remember when I got those two tickets? They were sort of like back to back, 3 days apart. Oops. Anyways, y'all took the radio out of it because I thought it was cool to get the car that had the radio that could come out of it. Well, it sucked. And I found the radio. It was in your dresser. And I would take the radio and I would put it in my car and I would drive to school and I would always beat you home from school. So I'd take the radio out, put it back in your dresser, and you guys never knew about it. So hope you're laughing right now. And good thing you already signed that other car over to me because you can't take it away now. Love you.
Here's a story. One time, y'all were out of town, and Jasmine went out of town, and she said that somebody needed to come feed the dogs. So I was like, okay, you know, we'll do it. And I sent Kim in there to do the alarm. She didn't know how to do it. And it just started going off. It was loud. And then y'all's neighborhood is big, you know. These people gonna call the police. The police gonna come. Mr. Tim gonna be mad. He gonna beat me up. They already said you did karate. Afro Samurai coming to get me. I don't know. But everything worked out for the better. We took care of the dogs, and now they got a family.
My funny story is not really funny because whenever I first moved into the house across the street, I was so excited, you know, only child, don't get to interact with many children. I saw Jasmine, Jordan, David, everybody on the back patio, and I started running. I darted for the back door. I knew I was gonna go and see my friends, and bam! Screen door busted. I'm sorry for breaking your screen door in your new house, Mr. Tim. I never said sorry for that. But happy birthday. 50 is a big number.
All right, I'm gonna pick up from where Diane left off. When she said floor, that means floor in your house. Tanya expected me to pick your big ass up and take you upstairs, but instead we brought the mattress down and laid your ass down in the hallway. Happy 50th, bruh.
43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50!
Keep your head away from windows, keep your arms inside the ride. Trust me with your body, trust me with your life. Banging on the windows, baby come inside. Certainly in trouble, maybe you should hide. I'ma tell you like, don't you look up to me, don't trust a word I say. Don't you end up like me if you learn one thing today. Don't you look up to me, don't trust a word I say. Don't you end up like me if you learn one thing today.
Thank you for not being a statistic.
Thank you for not being a statistic.
Thank you for not being a statistic.
Don't you look up to me, don't trust a word I say. Don't you end up like me if you learn one thing today. Don't you look up to me, don't trust a word I say. Don't you end up like me.
Happy birthday, big brother. Just want to say thank you for everything that you've done for the family, your mother, your brothers. If you've never heard it before, we do really appreciate you. And you are my idol. And one day I hope to grow up and be just like you. Love ya.
Careful. Don't trust a word I say. Careful. Trust a word I say, careful. If you learn one thing today,